Hey, Dr. Z, antibody tests, man. Should you even get one? So I have a lot of people coming up to me and they're like, bro, I got an antibody test. I'm good. It was negative. I've never had COVID. Or it was positive. I've had COVID, so I can go out in the world and do whatever I want, man, because I'm already immune. Okay, yeah, wrong, wrong, and wrong. So the Infectious Disease Society of America actually has guidelines on this now. And they basically say these tests are useless for the most part. And I'll tell you why, and then I'll tell you what they are good for. So they're useless because antibodies is what they're measuring. It's a blood test, right? So you're looking for past infection, because when you get infected with coronavirus, the body mounts a response where it creates these antibodies that bind to the virus and presumably try to knock it out of commission. Well, it turns out that more studies have shown, since this thing has come out, that these antibodies get less and less and less over time after you've been exposed. Maybe after 3 months, they may be not even detectable anymore. So if you were infected months ago, like you thought, man, I had a cold back in March or whatever, what? I bet I had COVID, let me get an antibody test, and it's negative, it doesn't tell you anything, because it could be that you've entirely, your antibodies are gone. Now, that doesn't mean you're not immune, because there's other ways that you can have immunity, T cells, B cells, but it's not easy to test for those. It's easy to test for antibodies, right? So what ends up happening is you may have what they call a false negative. So you're exposed, but you don't see it. Now, the other problem is you could test for these antibodies and the test could not be very good and you end up with a false positive. So a false positive means you were never exposed, but the test by a glitch says that you were. Well, that's a problem, because now you think you're immune to coronavirus and you go out in the world like full maskless, you know, not social distancing, bad idea. So not helpful. Now the thing is, so why even do it? Well, there's really only a couple circumstances where these tests right now are useful. And part of the reason is that the tests that are available, a lot of them are garbage. Right? Some of the commercial tests, the ELISA tests, they're better. So they have more, they have less false positives and less false negatives. So they may be better. And they turn around faster sometimes than the nasal test, because there's been such a backlog on the swabs and all that other stuff. So sometimes it's faster to get those, but they're not the test you want to do. The two circumstances where you can do this is you have a patient, say, who you're like, dude, bro, this guy has COVID. No doubt. But he keeps testing negative on the nasal PCR testing. So what is going on? Well, at that point, it may be reasonable to do an antibody test, because if it is positive, then you could say, well, okay, we're just not catching virus up here, but there may actually have been an infection. The second, or there's no access to those PCR tests. You have no choice. Well, okay, then you could do it. But the other one is for kids, and this is very rare, with this multi-system inflammatory syndrome of children, MISC. In those kids, presumably they were infected a while back, you can antibody test them just to see. Because if you get consistent positive, you could say, okay, well, now this person has probably been exposed to COVID and now has the syndrome that we see post-COVID very rarely in children. So those are the two instances where antibody testing. For everybody else, don't waste your money, don't waste your time yet until the tests get a lot better and we know a little bit more about how long the antibodies last. In the meantime, it's just three things. Wear a mask if you can't social distance, wash your hands, get tested if you have symptoms, and stay home. And that's it, and we get through it. All right, guys, I love you. We out.